when you're a solo content creator and you have to do everything yourself, from concept to execution to editing to delivery, you need to use all the tricks you can just to edit faster and be more efficient. Well, I guess this is my version of the ambitious but lazy trend right now. So here's what I did. The shortcut B is usually used if you want to switch to the blade tool. So I just switched it to cutting. And every time I press B, if my clip is selected, I'm cutting my clip immediately. I don't have to switch tools. I'm just pressing B and it will cut my clip right away. Trust me, it saves you seconds here and seconds there. And you know the rest, minutes here and minutes there and all that stuff. The other shortcuts that I changed is the trim to end shortcuts. And usually you use shift and bracket, left bracket to trim to that end and right bracket to trim that end. To speed up the process, I just got rid of the shift and just use bracket, left bracket and right bracket. Left bracket to trim to the left, right bracket to trim to the right. For my workflow, those are the shortcuts that I use the most. Cutting and trimming, cutting and trimming. That, just that little tweak changed my workflow, just speeds up my workflow. Let me give you another one that I used often that I think is a real cool trick. It's the end shortcut, and this time I'm not changing anything. End shortcut is for the magnetic timeline. It's used to activate it or deactivate it. So I usually keep it activated when I cut and trim and do all that stuff. But when I start to do some refining and put some sound effects here and sound effects there, because of all the cuts that I've already done, the magnetic timeline is actually not helping me, because if I move the sound effects here, the sound effects is so small, if I move the sound effect, it's just gonna be sucked into another cut that I don't really want it to be there. So I press and disable magnetic timeline, and then I can move these little tiny sound effects right here to where I want it, because I needed to match the movement in my animation. Here's the truth, you can't be lazy when you're a content creator. You enjoy creating content, you enjoy working on the concept, brainstorming with yourself, executing and editing and delivering, but if it can help you edit faster and be more efficient, why not? If you got any value from this one, subscribe and check out these other videos for Final Cut Pro users. We're trying to get back to weekly videos again, so don't miss out on that. I'll see you guys in the next one, hopefully. Peace.